Good. All of my stuff is in my locker.
Well, 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 if it isn't the little alien-loving nerd, Zachary Gurdle.
Oh shit, here we go again. What is it, Chandler? I don't want any problems with you. Also, people call me Zach, because Zachary is my full name, so get your facts straight.
Oh yeah, what are you going to do about it, Point Dexter?
Chandler, please, stop with the insults. I told you I don't want no problems with you. Not today. So please, leave me alone. Or else you'll get karma like before. You don't want that to happen again.
Whoa, calm down, Gurdle. Maybe I'll give you the silent treatment.
Yeah, and what is your silent treatment anyways?
Like this. Ha 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 ha. Now, take that, nerd.
Hey, you jerk. That's my glasses. Now I can't see thanks to you.
Silence, Gurdle. Ha 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 ha. Yes, finally, victory is mine. I win, I win, I win, I win. You lose, you lose, you lose, you lose. Take that, four eyes.
Hey, what's going on here? Chandler, what is wrong with you? What did you do to our friend?
I got my payback. Do you have a problem with that? Hey, what was that for?
Stop playing games with us. Why would you hurt our friend like that? Why would you break his glasses and knock him out?
Yeah, you know he couldn't see very well without his glasses. What gives you the right to make him look bad like this?
I broke his glasses and punched him in the eye, because I want payback on him for kicking me out of his house from his lame sleepover.
Are you serious? This is what it's all about. Payback? You're the one who is doing bad things to us, making our lives a living hell. That was so stupid and uncalled for.
You stupid red-headed freak. You broke my glasses and punched me in the eye over your stupid revenge. Now I can't see, thanks to you. You could have disfigured my eye. Since you did this to me, let me show you my own silent treatment to you.
Ouch, my tenders.
That's what you get. You shouldn't have not messed with me. Now, take that.
Yeah, that was a bad move for what you did to Zach.
Yeah, you always want to do stuff to other people, and then always wonder why you get in trouble and get grounded a lot. Think about it. Now, get out of our faces.
Screw this. I'm not having this with you all. You guys are not worth it anyway.
Stop it right there, Chandler. We saw what happened, and you are not getting away with this. That's it. Liam is going to give you what you deserve.
Oh yeah? Y'all cannot stop me. And how is some ginger brat going to take me down?
Like this.
Ouch, you bastard. My arm, you guys will pay for this.
Hey Liam, great job for borrowing one of Jill Valentine's tranquilizer dart guns. That was so smart and useful of that to stop Chandler.
Thanks, Stella. Now that Chandler is asleep, he will be snoring and snotting like Virginia.
Yep, you got that right, Liam. You should use these more often on him, or other troublemakers.
Yeah, you said it.
Oh my goodness, my eye. My eye hurts. It really hurts. Lincoln and Clyde, please help me.
Do not worry. We'll help you. Come over to the safe side, because there's glass all over the floor. It's okay, Zach. You're going to be okay.
Guys, come over here, now. Zach needs help.
Guys, quick. Zach is down. Come on, let's go help him.
Don't worry, Zach. We're coming. Hey, Zach, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. I just got a black eye by Chandler.
Don't worry, we'll buy you a new pair of glasses after school. Here, put these goggles on, you'll be able to see better.
Thanks, Stella. Without my glasses, I can no longer see, but with these goggles, it can help me see well.
Yeah, I'm hoping these goggles can work well as long as it can for you.
And Liam, good call on borrowing one of the tranquilizer dart guns from Jill Valentine. That should be able to stop Chandler.
Thank you very much, Zach. I did what I have to do to stop Chandler.
You're welcome, Liam.
Zach, please go to the nurse, because we can't have you walking around the school like this, because everyone else will feel very bad for you.
Yeah, it's better to go get your eye checked out by the nurse. Maybe there will be a way to get rid of the black eye.
Well, okay then. Somehow I do feel some little heartbeats inside of my swelled up eye.
How about I will take you to the nurse office? Just for your safety.
Well, all right. Sounds like a good idea.
Cool. Come on. Let's go. I will be right back. I got to make sure Zach is straight. It shouldn't take that long.
Man, poor Zach. I can't believe that Chandler caused this to him.
Yeah, I know. At least he stood up for himself.
I hope he will be okay.
Guys, look down. There's glass all over the floor. It came from Zach's glasses. I don't know how are we going to get this place cleaned up.
Hey Stella, I got an idea.
What is it, Lincoln?
Since Rusty is taking care of Zach, me and Clyde will take Chandler to Principal Ramirez, and you guys find some help to clean up the mess.
Well, that does sound like a good idea. Me and Liam will find some help, and we will work together to clean up this glass off of the floor.
Okay. Come on, Lincoln, let's go carry Chandler to the main office now, before anybody finds his body on the floor.
Sure thing, let's go.
Hey Liam, now that Lincoln and Clyde is handling Chandler, let's go find some others to help us clean up this area.
Okay, sounds cool.
Look over there, here comes Sonic and Tails. Maybe they can help us.
Hey Stella. Hey Liam. What's going on?
And also, there's glass on the floor next to you guys. Was there an accident or something?
No, Tails. This was more than an accident. This happened on purpose. Chandler wants his payback again, by breaking our friend's glasses, and punched him in the eye. It's a good thing that Liam shot that jerk with one of Jill Valentine's tranquilizer dart guns, and Lincoln had to carry Chandler to Principal Ramirez's office along with Clyde.
Not only that, he even called him bad names, and calling his full name, Zachary.
Now that you guys are here, is it okay if you can help us clean up this area? We can't do this work alone.
Oh my god. Stella and Liam, I'm so sorry about what happened to your friend. I hope your friend Zach will be okay. And of course, we'll help y'all clean up this mess.
Excellent. We're glad that you can work with us. How about we look for some brooms and a dustpan from the janitor's closet, so that way we can clean this area up?
Okay, sounds cool. The janitor's room is not far from here, and there are plenty of brooms we can use.
And somebody will have to create like a caution sign. That way they will know that there's broken glass on the floor.
Don't worry, Tails. I will work on that. So, with that being said, let's go get the brooms and clean this mess up. Come on, let's go.
Hello, Lincoln. Hello, Clyde. What brings you here today? And why is Chandler sleeping?
Chandler was picking on one of my friends, Zach Gurdle. He broke his glasses and punched him in the eye, just for getting his payback on one of us.
Oh my gosh. That's horrible. Is Zach okay?
Yeah, he's okay. Rusty is escorting him to the nurse to get his eye checked out.
And it's a good thing that our friend, Liam Hunnicutt, took down Chandler by using one of Jill Valentine's tranquilizer dart guns.
Okay, is there anything else?
Well, Stella and Liam on the other hand, they are just finding some help, so they can clean up the area, because there's glass in the hallway.
Do not worry, I will keep a sharp eye on him. You guys keep checking on Zach, and make sure your friends clean up the mess up in the hallway, and I will handle Chandler.
Okay, will do. We will always look out for each other. And, thanks for dealing with Chandler for us.
No problem, Lincoln. Happy to help.
Hey, Clyde. Now that's out of the way, let's go check on Stella and Liam first, just to make sure they clean up that glass on the floor. Then, we go check on Zach.
Okay, that actually sounds like a good idea. Let's go.
Man, I cannot believe he caused all of this to Zach. That's it. I'm calling his parents to make him pay the price. And, I'm also calling Zach's parents about what happened to him. And plus, I noticed he got tranquilized. So, the drowsiness of him doesn't last until 1 hour. He will be awake soon.
Hey Stella, hey Liam. I see that Sonic and Tails are helping you clean up the hallway.
Yeah, they bumped into us. We told them what happened, and they decided to help us. And, good thing I made up this caution sign, just to let others know there's glass on the floor.
Oh, okay, we can see that. That's a smart strategy right there, Stella. That way other people won't get glass caught on their shoes or feet.
Hey Lincoln and Clyde, don't worry. Me and Tails will handle this. Just go check on your friend, and we will let you guys know that the floor is cleaned up.
Okay, great. Thanks you guys for helping out our friends. We really appreciate that. You're welcome, Lincoln.
Anyways, we are about to go to the nurse office now to check on Zach. Rusty is probably still over there looking after him. But, we will be back shortly.
Okay. Send our regards to Zach Gurdle.
See you when you get back.
Man, I can't believe Chandler broke Zach's glasses and knocked him out by punching him in the eye. That was so dumb and stupid of him, and he even called him bad names.
Yeah, you said it. He's so responsible for doing that nonsense. I'm glad he was sent to Principal Ramirez's office immediately.
I know, buddy. It's like the last time we'd beat him up for his punishment night few months ago, when he broke into Zach's house and nearly ruined his sleepover. I hope he start getting karma once again. Because this serves him right for what he did today.
Don't worry, guys. He will. Soon.
Okay, Zach. The nurse will be with you in about few minutes. Just sit there and wait, and maybe you might get some company.
Okay. Thanks, Maribel.
Yeah, thank you, Maribel.
You're very welcome, Zach and Rusty. Man, poor little Zach. Why does it always have to be Chandler?
Don't worry, Zach. Everything's going to be all right.
Okay.
Hey, look. There's Lincoln and Clyde.
Hey, Rusty, how is he doing?
His eye is still swollen, but he's still doing okay. Maribel said that the nurse will be here in about few minutes.
Okay, good. At least we brought Chandler to the main office with Principal Ramirez, so she is keeping an eye on him. And we thought we might stop by to check on Zach.
Hey, Lincoln and Clyde. Thank you guys for checking on me and looking after me.
You're welcome, Zach. That's what friends do. We look after each other.
Yeah, always. And forever.
Hey, Zach. If you don't mind, is it okay if I can check out your eye? Don't worry. I'll be gentle.
Sure. Ouch. It hurts.
I know, buddy. Few more seconds. Well, it doesn't look that bad. The nurse is going to find some ways to get rid of the swelling.
Yeah, he or she is probably going to give you like an eye medicine, or a pain reliever. That way it can make the swelling go away.
Listen, it's not your fault. You stand up for yourself, which is good. It was a bad move by Chandler. He caused all of this to you. We promise you he will pay for what he did. As soon as he is handled by Principal Ramirez, we will get back at him.
But every time we do that, he is still coming after us. I don't understand why is he keep trying to make our lives miserable.
We don't know, Zach. We don't know.
But, it is not your fault that you took a stand for yourself. You did the right thing. Chandler will be the one paying the price. That was the biggest mistake he has ever made.
Well, I guess you were right about that.
We feel very bad for you, buddy. We know you didn't deserve this.
Yeah, we are so sorry, Zach. We really are.
Hey guys, we heard what happened. Is Zach okay?
Yes, Ash. He is okay.
Okay, cool. And Zach, did Chandler make you feel bad?
Yeah, he most certainly have. But Chandler is going to pay for what he did to me. He could have messed up my vision really bad.
Don't worry, Zach. I'm sure that red-headed jerk is going to receive karma again, right, Ash?
Yeah, Brock, I agree with you. Anyways, Zach, if it makes you feel better, me and Brock will take you to the school nurse in order to amputate your black eye.
Thanks, Ash and Brock, that would be nice. But, who is the school nurse?
Her name is Nurse Joy. She is a great nurse, and takes care of a lot of people in this school. And, she's also a great doctor.
Well, she does sound very useful to me. I hope she will find good ways to get rid of the swelling of my eye.
Don't worry. She will.
Next patient, Zach Gurdle. Please go meet Nurse Joy at room 158.
Okay, buddy. That's you. Come on. Let's go.
Okay, guys. I'm coming.
Hey, Ash and Brock. Thank you so much for taking care of our friend. And Ash, though you saved me from Chandler before, and now you are doing good things for one of my friends.
You're welcome, Lincoln. It's good to help some people I care about.
We are praying for you, Zach. Please feel better.
Thanks, you guys. Thank you for all of your support.
You're welcome, Zach. Take care, buddy.
Okay. Now that's taken care of, let's go back to our classes.
Yeah, sure. Thank you guys for looking after my best pal. I appreciated that.
You're very welcome, Rusty. That is what friends are for.
Anyways, now that's out of the way, let's go check on Stella and Liam. I think they already finished the hallway, with the help of Sonic and Tails.
Sure, let's go check on them now.
Hey guys. We just wanted to let you know that we cleaned up the mess, thanks to Sonic and Tails.
Alright, Stella. That's great to hear.
Anyways, how's everything going with Zach?
Everything worked out great. Ash, Ketchum and Brock has escorted him to Nurse Joy. Hopefully, she will find a great way to get rid of his swollen eye.
Okay, excellent. That is great to hear. We are also keeping Zach in our prayers.
Yeah, hopefully the nurse will use like some eye medicine, a pain reliever, or just a ice pack. But, I'm sure he will be alright.
Yeah, let's hope for the best. Anyways, let's get to your classes, or else we will be late.
Sure, Clyde. Let's go.
Hi, good afternoon. This is Principal Ramirez speaking. Is this the McCann parents? Good. I'm calling because Chandler is causing more trouble in this school again. He's still wanting his so-called revenge on some kids who are innocent. He insulted one of Lincoln's friends, Zach Gurdle. He broke his glasses, and punched him in the eye.
What? Are you fucking kidding me right now? That stupid little brat. Who the fuck does he think he is?
Mr. McCann. I know you are frustrated. I understand your anger. Don't worry. He will be on a 4-month suspension from school until next semester. And, please think of something else that will be useful for him during his suspension.
Okay, a military school will definitely work for him, and going to make sure he is going to get a job that will be hard and confusing for him, so he can be pushed around.
Good, that sounds like a great idea from you. I will call you back for any updates.
Okay, thank you for your help, Principal Ramirez.
You're welcome, Mr. McCann. Goodbye. Okay, now that I called Chandler's parents, now it's time to call Zach's parents.
All Alright guys, our king is knocked out cold, y'all better make sure you idiots get a lot of power gained up to his brain and waking him up, so hustle, now. Hey, you, hurry it up, what do you think I'm paying you for? You don't pay me, we don't even exist, we're just a clever visual metaphor used to personify the abstract concept of thought. One more crack like that and you're out of here. No, please, I have 5 kids. Then get your ass back to work, or else, Wedgie. Everyone, hurry up, work very hard to get his system working, no breaks, hustle 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 hustle.
Absolutely, it's being taken care of. Yes, I understand your frustration. I'm very sorry about your son, but do not worry, your son will be okay, and Chandler will be the one to pay the consequences. Absolutely, happy to help. I will keep you posted about Zach. Okay, goodbye. Okay, now that's done, just a few more minutes until the drowsiness wear off of him. He will be awake anytime now.
And that's how I got this black eye.
Oh my goodness. That's horrible. I can't believe he would do this to you.
Yeah, I guess I'm gonna have to stay like this, if the pain doesn't go away.
Wow, Zach. I'm so sorry to hear that. But don't feel bad, I'm going to do whatever I can to make sure I get rid of the swelling on your eye.
Okay. Thank you, Nurse Joy.
You're welcome, Zach. Here, let me put this ice pack on you. It's going to help you heal up your eye.
Ouch.
Shh. It's okay, it's not going to hurt. Okay, that should do it for now. I'm going to head out for a few minutes, so I can get some things for your eye. Just relax here for a while. Here. You can borrow my iPad, just in case if you get bored.
Thank you very much. I appreciate that.
No problem. I'm just doing my job.
Hey Nurse Joy. How is Zach doing?
Hey Maribel. He's doing okay. Swelled up, but he's alright. I just got to find some eye medicine, and probably some eye drops.
Okay, good. Is it okay if I can come with you and help you out? Because I don't want that little kid to be feeling bad for himself. It breaks my heart to see him like this.
Sure you can, Maribel. Also, I let him borrow my iPad in case he gets bored and hopefully he will have some company to stop by.
Okay, sounds like a good idea. Come on, let's go find some things to make Zach better.
Okay. Let's go.
Ha, this video is actually kinda funny.
Hello, Zach.
Oh, hello Sally Acorn. What an unexpected surprise. What brings you here?
Lincoln Loud told me what happened to you, so I thought I just came by here just to check and see if you're alright. I am very sorry that you have to go through this today.
Yeah, I know. I couldn't believe it either. He keeps on making our lives miserable. I don't know why is he keep doing those bad things to us. This makes me, Lincoln, and the rest of us shattered. I don't know what we're going to do.
Zach, it's okay. Please don't feel bad for yourself. You did the right thing, and it is not your fault. It's never your fault that you took a stand for yourself. You know, some things like that can happen to you sometimes. There's some ways you can solve problems like this. Rather you walk away from it, or you hold your ground. Sometimes you do it with or without some people on your side. Nobody in this school blamed you for what you did today. Chandler did it the hard way, and he will learn from that.
Well, you may be right about that.
Can I take a look at your eye, please? Oh my goodness.
Yeah, I know. It looks bad.
It's not that bad. But don't worry, everything's going to be alright. Nurse Joy will take care of you. And hopefully your friends will find a way to buy some glasses for you.
Thanks for cheering me up, Sally. I really, really appreciate that.
Oh, you're welcome, Zach. Here, put the ice pack back on, so your eye can heal up. Well, I must get going. And also, be brave, and be strong.
Don't worry, Sally. I will. Thanks for checking on me.
Anytime. Goodbye, Zach.
Wow. Sally seems very nice.
Hello, Zach. How are you feeling?
Hello, Nurse Joy. I'm doing okay. Good thing that your iPad kept me comfortable. And Sally Acorn decided to comfort and cheer me up.
Okay, that's good to hear. Anyways, how is your eye doing?
Not bad. It's still swollen, but not bad.
Okay. I got all the things I need to help you with fixing your eye. So, let's get started.
Okay, sounds great.
Good. Now, all I need you to do is to place the ice pack and my iPad on the table next to me. Because I want you to lie down in order to fix your eye.
Okay.
Good. Now, let's begin.
Okay, it passed 1 hour. It's time for him to wake up. Rise and shine, Chandler. I hope you had a good nap, and now, it's time for you to come clean. You are going to explain to me about what happened. And, it better not be a lie. If you are lying, you will be far from trouble. You will be in very, big, trouble. So, talk right now.
Okay, I was picking on Zach, by breaking his glasses and punched him in the eye, because, I wanted my revenge on him by kicking me out of his sleepover before. And, me, getting karma all of the time.
Chandler. Seriously. This is so unacceptable. How dare you broke Zach's glasses, and punched him in the eye. You know he couldn't see without his glasses. He is now in the nurse office, thanks to you. This is not funny. That was the stupidest thing you have ever done in your troublemaking life. What do you have to say about that?
I'm sorry. I was just so angry and frustrated, because I wanted payback against Lincoln and his friends. They treated me badly.
Have you got cotton in your ears? You are the one who was treating them badly. Because they do not like your attitude, and your behavior. This is all your fault. Not only that, you even insulted Zach by calling him names that he does not like, meaning that you hurt his feelings. You should be ashamed of yourself.
I know. I am so sorry, I was only playing around with him. Can you please give me one more chance?
Nope. Absolutely not. Not going to happen. Why would I give chances for a troublemaker like you? You should have dropped the ball, and become a regular student. There's your answer.
Principal Ramirez, please, I'm begging you.
You can beg all you want. I'm sorry, Chandler, but the bad things you have done is so unforgivable. I have no choice but to put you on suspension for 4 months. And you will be signing up for military school. Your father accepted it. You will not come back until you learn your own valuable lesson. This serves you right. With that being said, Jill Valentine is waiting for you to be escorted home right away. Your parents are home, and they will be very disappointed at you. Now, get out of my school, and don't come back until your suspension is done. This conversation is over, and have fun getting grounded by your parents. You stupid red-headed jerk.
I hate my life.
I'm so glad that this is my last time escorting you home for now. Hell, I need a break from you anyways, because you always doing bad things that nobody like. Don't you even dare try to blame it on somebody else but yourself. You got what you deserve. Zach Gurdle was just a kid, and you broke his glasses and knocked him out, and you was calling him names. What gives you the right to do that to a poor kid? What gives you the right to get your revenge on people you hate for no reason? You know what? Since you are going to the military school during your suspension, hopefully one day you will stop being a stupid, ugly, troublemaking, red-headed jerk. Shut up, Chandler. This serves you right. You will learn your lesson one day.
God damn it, Chandler. When is this going to stop for once in your life? How dare you break Zach's glasses and punched him in the eye over your nonsense? And you even called him names, which made his feelings hurt. Not only that, you could have messed up his vision when you punched him. How could you do that to him? You know what? I'm giving you a silent treatment now. There. That should do it. And also, you are grounded. You are grounded for 4 months, until your suspension is over. I've signed you up for military school, so, with that being said, look at me when I'm talking to you. Good. With that being said, go to your room now, and start packing up your stuff so we can get you the military school. I'll be watching you. Good. Now have fun. You stupid, pathetic, red-headed bitch of a son.
Hey, Zach. We're so happy that your eye is fixed. And we can see the nurse Joy gave you an ice cream as a reward.
Yeah, you were right, Lincoln. She gave me that for being strong and brave while she was fixing up my eye.
That's good for you, Zach. We're so glad that you're feeling better right now. And Chandler is off from school on his 4-month suspension and getting sent to military school. Thanks to the help by Principal Ramirez.
And we are going to the eyewear store, like I promised, just to buy you a new pair of glasses, so you can see well.
That sounds like a great idea, Stella. Let's go.
Hey, you guys.
Oh, that's my friend, Peter Pan. What's up?
Sally Acorn told me about what happened to Zach, so I got something to give him.
Yes. Yes, 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 yes. My glasses, now I can see well. Thank you so much, Peter Pan.
You're very welcome, Zach. Me and Sally went to Imart Express, just to buy the same pair of glasses for you. I flew us there, and hoping this will make you feel better.
Y'all did that for me. Thanks again, Peter Pan. And thank you, Sally. I owe you guys one.
You're welcome, Zach. We did it all for you.
Hey, Zach, if this can also make you feel better, how about you spend a night with us at my house? I'll remind your parents to let them know you needed some company.
Really? That sounds really great, Lincoln. It will be just like the last time I hosted my sleepover.
Okay, guys, you'll go and have some fun. I have some things I got to handle with babysitting. I will see you guys soon.
Sure thing. We'll see you soon, Peter Pan, and thanks for hooking up my best pal.
It was my pleasure.
Okay, guys, I have to head off too. I need to get back to my Sonic universe.
Sure thing, Sally. And thank you so much for checking and comforting our friend. That was the nicest thing you have ever done for him.
You're welcome, Lincoln. It was my pleasure to cheer anybody up.
Goodbye, Sally. Thanks for the hospitality.
Anytime, Zach. Well, gotta go. See you guys soon. Goodbye.
Hey, Zach, we are so glad you got your new pair of glasses.
Yeah, thanks to the help of Peter Pan, along with Sally Acorn, now you can see very well.
Yep, you said it, Liam.
Anyways, now that Chandler is suspended and off to military school, and Zach is feeling better, let's go celebrate by going to Gus game and grub.
Yeah, sounds like a great idea, Lincoln. Let's go.
Welcome everyone to our lesson of the day. The moral of this story is, once other people are wearing glasses, it's never okay to call people names and insulting them.
The more you insult, the more you can hurt other people's feelings.
Once people are in bad condition, It is important to take care of them and make sure everyone is healed up.
Comforting other people shows that we care or we love each other. It can also turn things around in life whenever you're feeling down.
There is two choices in reality. You can either stand up for yourself or you can walk away. Once you stand up for yourself, you must think before you act. And finally, once you walk away from your problem, do not let your anger out on someone who mistreats you. Because sometimes, it can make things worse.
Once you're getting into problems like this, it is important to make good decisions in your life, just to make things on what is right for you and others.
That is it for lesson of the day. Take care of yourselves, and please be safe.